With its wide potential for application including games and movies, virtual reality is a key technology of the fourth industrial revolution. A special event displaying the latest related trends provides a glimpse of the future by offering visitors a chance to try out new devices. Lee Min-sun takes us to the annual Korea VR Festival.
Seoul might seem like a place where it's impossible to experience skydiving, but not so for visitors at the five-day Korea VR Festival. Under the theme, Experience the Fourth Industrial Revolution Through Virtual Reality, the festival kicked off its third edition Wednesday in the Sangam-dong area. In virtual reality, visitors can try all kinds of shooting, sports and musical games.
I tried this VR game and it felt real and natural. It was fun to play.
If you're worn out on activities, you can sit back in massage chair and have a relaxing time in a virtual reality forest. Or test your nerves by walking on the edge of a tall building.
It was really scary. It felt so real that I cried.
You can even check out the meeting room where the historic Inter-Korean Summit was held in April.
Not only can visitors enjoy various VR games and experiences, but also they can get a glimpse into the future of VR technology.
Scores of companies are showcasing a range of VR products and services that will be used in military training, machine maintenance, education and medical surgery. The medical sector, in fact, is one of the most promising industries looking to adopt the technology. Patients can simply put on the VR gear to get psychological consultation and therapy. And doctors can polish up their surgery skills with the VR training program.
The Internet of Things, AI and 5G are the basic technologies of the fourth industrial revolution. It is expected that many kinds of services will be combined with VR and AR devices, and 5G will be commercialized next year.
Although the VR is not fully ready for customers yet, experts hope commercialization will speed up as the accompanying technologies improve. Lee Min-sun, Arirang News.